Hey guys, so I want to clarify some what I think to be really important points about what scientific consensus is and why we should be taking it much more seriously than we do as a society. So, full disclosure, I am a scientist, so there's inherent bias there. But it also means that I have an insider's take on what science actually is and what it takes to reach scientific consensus. So understand something. Scientists work tirelessly to try to answer scientific questions. I'm a natural scientist. I work in the ocean mostly. I ask questions about how the ecosystems in the ocean function so that we can better understand how to conserve these systems. I spend hundreds of hours, maybe even thousands of hours per study that I produce, that I then publish, and I share with other professionals in my discipline. And they read these studies and they produce their own studies, and we try to come together and understand general principles about how the world works. In my case, the ocean, but there, of course, are various scientific disciplines. And the point here is that you have individuals exerting incredible amounts of effort to try to understand the answers to the questions they're asking in their discipline. When you have many, many independent scientists conduct many independent studies, we're talking, in some cases, careers worth of studies, that point to similar answers, this can drive consensus in the scientific community, meaning scientists in that discipline generally agree that a specific phenomenon is real, it is happening, and we understand the underlying mechanisms in this way. This is incredibly rare. I don't think people appreciate just how rare scientific consensus is. And the reason it is so rare is that many, many patterns, again, I'll talk about nature because I'm a natural scientist, many, many patterns in nature exhibit tremendous variability. So there's a lot of variability among data points when you're conducting a study, and there's often lots of variability among studies. So it is incredibly rare that many, many, many studies point to the same conclusion. And so when this happens and it yields a consensus in the scientific community, scientists take it incredibly seriously. Do we question it? Of course, we're always conducting more science to answer more questions and to attempt to test how robust this pattern of this pattern that we have decided seems to be real is. We're constantly testing it. So is it the word of God? Absolutely not. But it is very important to take very seriously anything that the scientific community, again, a ton of independent researchers collecting tons of independent pieces of evidence to try to answer questions. When this community says something seems to be real, we should really be taking it seriously as a society. This has zero political drive. There is no hidden agenda. Scientific consensus is not frivolous. It is not handed out willy-nilly. It is a painstaking process to reach. We're talking generations, decades, maybe more than that, of the brightest minds in the world, some of the brightest minds in the world, working toward answers. And then when they come to a consensus, we really need to be thinking about that and implementing the conclusions that those scientists, that discipline has drawn, so that we can guide the progress of our civilization appropriately. This has nothing to do with political affiliation, religion, background, economic status, race, none of that stuff. Science is meant to serve everyone, and when scientific consensus is reached, society as a whole ought to be paying close attention to that. The future of our species depends on it. Thank you for watching. Help me spread information, not misinformation. Help me fight misinformation. Help me spread information about science, how it works, why it's important, why we should care, why we should listen, by liking on Facebook, subscribing on YouTube, sharing these videos, and together maybe we can make a little bit of a difference. Thanks.